It's the end of the road.
Please, Shannon.
Text me every day, okay?
I will. Every day.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your judges, Randy Jackson, Jennifer Lopez, and Steven Tyler. And your host, Ryan Seacrest.
Another week of intense competition. At this stage, the race to the title is closer than ever. The good news is, I love you, darling. Thank you very much. The good news is all the finalists will be coming to a city near you this summer on the Idol Tour, but this is no time to relax. Things are heating up, starting with our theme, the incredible songbook of Billy Joel. Now, Steven, you sang with Billy. What do the contestants need to know about these songs, need to understand about these songs?
I'm thinking that if you can't sing Billy Joel, you can't sing at all. Wow. Billy Joel is an American icon of all time, and his songs have great melody. That's what it's all about.
So a true test tonight. All right.
True test.
Not only did Jimmy Iovine supervise the songs, but he also brought in music heavy hitter Diddy to help out. Plus, fashion mogul Tommy Hilfiger was on hand to give the idols style advice. Here is what our superstar team of experts had to say about DeAndre. Let's go.
DeAndre, do me a favor. Mm-hmm. Take that hair off.
Oh, it looks so bad right now.
I think it's very cool.
I think his hair pulled back was sort of a waste of that hair.
Who has that hair? Nobody else has that hair.
No.
What else could we do to make him look like a real superstar? He's got a look already. If we could put him in an incredible outfit, he's got that hair and great music, I mean, that's really the perfect scenario for him.
How do you feel about maybe studying or embellishing some of like the shoulders and the collar?
But we don't want to do too much either. We want to give you a look that enhances the look you have already.
Thank you.
Great to meet you.
Great to meet you too.
And
thank you
luck.
So much.
I think it's going to be a very big week for DeAndre. It'll be a huge week for him.
How you doing?
Good.
What song you doing?
Only the Good Diane.
Only Good Diane. That should be good for you, right? You had a little trouble last time, right?
Yeah. Okay. Last week, not the business.
DeAndre came in nervous, really solemn in the song. Wait, stop. If you can't smile when you sing this song,
gotcha.
You can't smile.
Meeting with Jimmy and Diddy was kind of intimidating at first.
This is a very hard song to do. Billy Joel is at his hottest right here.
And I He can do this. Think of what the song is about. You're 16, you're 17, you're 18 years old, whatever
why
it is.
I'm here. I just would like to.
You, I
yes.
Because
when we walk into the whole repressed Catholic thing. That's my area. Okay? Where afraid to walk up to a girl at 17 years old is my area. That is not your area.
You have to be in that mode. You have to channel Billy Joel's life at that point. He's talking only the good die young. He has Christie Brinkley off to the side. You don't even know who that is.
I do know that. Okay.
But she is like off to the side and money's falling out the sky. There's mansions and 767s.
You don't like, get no hotter than this. This is like extra stretch limo before they put the super stretch out.
Only the good die young. Much, much better. You know, remember, the first four lines look straight at Jennifer. Gotcha. She's a Catholic girl. She'll get it in 2 seconds. I don't know. He probably knows better than me, but I believe she'll get it, right?
She'll get it.
It's about what people do from 16 to 18 years old when they're trying to convince another person to do something that those people's parents don't want them to do, right?
Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go! Woo! If he doesn't have fun with that song, I mean...
D-O-A.
Yeah, D-O-A.
Too late, I was another later. Comes down to pay. I might as well be the one where they sold you a statue, told you to pray. They built you a temple and locked you away. Ah, but they never told you price they would pay. The things that you might have done, I'll tell you only the good time. Tell you only the good die. That's what I said. Yeah. Only the good die. Only the good die. Only the good. Ooh. Only the good. Ooh. Only the good die. Only the good die. Only the good die.
You got some fans here. DeAndre, man, first I thought it was a little too happy, but isn't that what the world needs right about now? Yeah. Only the good die young. I guess that's why you and I are still here, Randy.
Yes. Yes. Something like that. Yeah.
I thought it was a great way to start the show. I really like that you had a laid-back vibe when, because that's your vibe. You have a little bit of that islandy kind of Bob Marley-ish feel to me, and you had a little bit of that in there. But also, when he needed to be grovelly and hard, it got that too. So I thought it was a good job. It was a nice mix. It really showcased who you were. I thought you did a good job.
Yo. I gotta echo that. I think it was a great way to start a show. I wasn't jumping up and down because it didn't show me anything special. No, but hang on.
The jumps, and no. The little sweat.
I did like the little skip and the jumps. That was kind of nice. But listen, I think it was a good job. I don't know if it was like great. It didn't wow me, but it was okay. Okay. It was. It's all right.
Randy has to start us off with a buzzkill. Randy.
I mean,
they thought it was a good way to start the show, right?
I really did.
Very nice.
Yeah, anyway, how you doing, buddy? How's the prep been for you this week?
Easier. Much better than last week.
Good.
Lord have mercy.
All right, you want to vote for DeAndre? It's 1-866-IDLE-01. 1-866-436-5701. If you're with AT&T, you can text it or vote to 5701. You can also vote online at AmericanIdol.com. Lines open at the end of the show and will stay open for at least 2 hours. These are 866 numbers, not 800. So please dial carefully. Good luck, DeAndre. Thank you very much. After this break, our New Englander takes on an Empire State anthem. Don't miss Erica next live.
Tonight, you know, I felt good about what I did. I had fun. Randy didn't like it as much, but you know, you can't please everybody.
Tonight, our top 10 taking on the legendary Billy Joel under the watchful eyes of Jimmy and Diddy. The finalists also getting style advice from Tommy Hilfiger. And all of them had a lot to say about Erica. Take a look.
I'm doing New York State of Mind.
Oh, okay. That's a good start.
New York State of Mind is an anthem. It's an anthem for Billy Joel. It's an anthem for New Yorkers.
State of Mind.
You're doing a famous song by Billy Joel that everybody knows. Hold back a little bit, and pay respect to the song instead of just trying to overperform it.
I'm afraid of her oversinging. Of course, the judges are sensitive to that right now. They've made the audience sensitive to it if they weren't already.
Have you ever been to New York?
Oh, yeah. I'm not a New Yorker. I'm a Rhode Islander, but I love New York.
See, you gotta be a New Yorker. When you're singing this song, you have to be a New Yorker. We wanted to do it like you're doing it in Yankee Stadium.
In the back of my mind, I'm like, oh man, oh, Red Sox Nation, they're gonna be so mad.
You gotta get raw, it's representing New York, take some risks, and show them that you have some guts and you wanna win this competition.
I feel if she really channels her energy and she stays in character and delivers it like a New Yorker walking down the street, Billy Joel style, home run.
Who's your favorite musician? Or who do you really idolize and look up to?
I really love Pink. You know, I mean, she's definitely got that.
She has a definite look. I mean, she's got a very distinct rock and roll look. Pink has very short hair. And I'm looking at Erica's hair, and I'm thinking, this hair is taking away from your look. When you lift the hair up, you see your jawbone, you see your neck, you see the proportion of your skull, your head.
Yeah.
Maybe you do something similar. It could be very cool, like a punk cut. It could be amazing.
I'm here doing American Idol, you know, the biggest adventure I've ever had in my life. Why wouldn't I chop all my hair off? Like, sure.
I really believe that America will see her before and after, and the votes will come in positive.
Hopefully you guys like it, and I'll see you on stage.
Some folks like to get away, take a holiday from the neighborhood. Have a flight to Miami Beach or to Hollywood. But I'm taking a Greyhound on the Hudson River line. I'm in a New York state of mind. State of mind. New York. state of mind.
Yeah, give it up for her. That's Skyfly. Give it up. Give it up. Let me just say this. First of all, I love the look. I love the short do. It's hot.
It's so different.
It's so different. Jennifer didn't even recognize. She's like, oh, my God.
I was looking past you. Then all of a sudden, I was like, oh, my God, that's her.
Dude, I love that, and I love the vocals. I think you're one of the best singers in this whole thing this season, right? And listen, you can clearly sing the phone book. That was beautiful there, too. I'll give you one piece of advice. They were right. Jimmy was right about the over-singing, whatever, whatever. But those that can do should. Those that can't do shouldn't, right? So at the end of that song, even Steven started singing. You didn't hear him. They need to have a mic on him while you're singing. He even went to a run at the end. You can go to some runs and take those liberties because you can do that. So go ahead and treat the song like it should be in the front. By the time you get to the end, wear us out because you got that. You know what I'm saying? Very, very nice. I love it.
I agree. It was such a beautiful, beautiful vocal. I mean, when you went really... I love you guys, too. Okay. I was saying you were great. That's what I know I was saying that. But I agree. I think that there's, and I love the hair, too, by the way. It gives me a Pat Benatar vibe from the 80s. I don't know, something really, really hot. But I'd love to see you more, like when he let loose vocally at the end, but also let loose all through your body, too, to bring in that performance, to really take us home. You know what I mean? Because like he said, you have the chops to do that. And then when you incorporate that, it was like, I wanted to see you unplant your feet and really move around and really feel what you were singing about. That would be my only note, too, because, like I said, the vocal was beautiful.
Yeah.
I agree with both of them. You could have put more character into it, but later for that. We already know you can sing great. You put a lot of personality into that, as Billy Joel did writing these songs. And I think you wore it, like, beautiful. Just nice. Outstanding.
Yes. Thank you. Yes.
Hello. I love it.
Thanks.
Not since the Sanjaya Ponyhawk have we seen such a transformation on this show with hair. But that is...
Yeah.
I was reading the Twitter feed backstage, and people love it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, instant feedback right here.
Yay.
So,
awesome.
Looking
like
good.
You have time to read Twitter backstage?
What's that?
You have time to read Twitter backstage?
I multitask well, Randy. Come on. I was also having dinner. If you'd like to vote for Erica, it's 1-866-IDLE-02, 1-866-436-5702, or you can text the word VOTE to 5702. Calls are toll-free from a landline. Standard text rates apply. You can also vote online at AmericanIdol.com. Thank you very much. Good job. Hey, when we come back, the guy who Jimmy said came in first, second, and third place last week, Joshua, next. Hang on.
Okay, so honestly, I feel so good about that performance. I mean, I was 100% myself, and I just want America to believe in me like I believe in myself.
You're locked live on Idol. We're opening up the prolific songbook of Billy Joel this evening. Here is Joshua's game plan. Take a look.
Having Tommy Hilfiger on the show is gonna be so much fun. I know his ideas would be a great asset.
What have you chosen?
I've chosen just like all black this week.
All black this week?
Yeah.
I think you're more special than that. I would like to see him in a tuxedo, maybe go black tie. I think Joshua has the opportunity to really become polished. And I think by dressing him up, it will do that. I think you're 40.
He's a 40, but he actually likes to wear 38 because he likes things super fitted.
I think that's very smart because super fitted, I think, makes it look very tailored. I think that cleanly polished, he's going to look like a very experienced superstar.
This week I'm singing She's Got Away by Billy Joel.
Joshua, you ever heard this song before?
I've never heard this song before.
This fella, Percy Sledge, wrote an email in saying how much he loved when he did When a Man Loves a Woman on the show.
That's great.
Yeah, really, he really killed it.
This song is definitely different. It's a pop song, and everyone knows my roots is soulful. Making the song fit my voice was definitely a big challenge.
I think that you have like that little rough spot. I don't think you have to go so harsh and make it so like screamy right in there.
It sounded like James Earl Jones ghosted into your body for a minute.
Joshua, you know, he's been one of the standouts in the competition. He's a very vulnerable artist. When he performs, that's why we connect with him.
I definitely went into the mentor session worried and discouraged. I kind of didn't connect with the song at first.
I just feel like there's something else on your mind. I need you to put that to the side, and I need you here with me.
Just him telling me that made me realize I have to give my all this next performance.
Once we got him to be present and be all the way there, I mean, it's magic.
She's got a way. But I know that I can't live without her. She's got a way of pleasing. I don't know why it is, but that doesn't have to be a reason anywhere. She's got a smile that heals me. I don't know. But I have to laugh when she reveals me. She's got a way of talking. I don't know why it is, but it lifts me up when we are walking anywhere. She comes to me when I'm feeling down. Without a sound, she touches me. I can turn around. Whoa, whoa, whoa. She's got a smile that kills me. Yeah. I don't know why it is, but I don't have to be.
You know, Billy Joel wrote his life in his songs, you know what I mean? He wrote it in such a beautiful and descriptive way that when you sing his lyrics, you know, because they're so amazing, you should really, really feel that. I feel stupid kind of to say anything negative in any way because you sing so crazy. It's so, you know... when the choir came out, I just know that that's where you live and that's where you get comfortable. But I think for me, with a song like that, and I love that song so much, and I know probably most of America who knows that song loves that song so much, that I just needed to feel like you were connected more to the lyrics and what you were saying. You know, you, obviously when he wrote that song, he wrote it about somebody who just rocked his world in the biggest way. Right. Do you know what I mean, baby? Yeah. Do you know what I'm saying about that? And I felt like you were singing it, but you weren't singing it. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, most definitely.
Okay. Well, Joshua.
It was
Steven,
still beautiful.
Steven Tyler.
It was still, those are just a little note for you. That's it.
All right, well Joshua, I think that you took a song that I don't know. I don't not know that song of Billy Joel's, and I wasn't too up on it when I first heard it, and it was only because I didn't know it. What you did
was you sang your life into it and you made a song that I didn't know come to life with your soul and with your heart. Okay? I think you sang the sweat out of that song.
You sang it. I don't know how you felt it.
Well, this kind of puts me in an interesting position. Both of my co-judges have disagreed, sort of. I can see where they're both coming from, because Jennifer's right on the one hand. I will say this, because you said when walking into the mentoring session with Jimmy and Diddy that you felt kind of defeated. Dude, with a voice like yours and a talent like yours, never, ever feel defeated. You're always ahead. You can always, as you did in the end when the choir came out, turn that on. So always just jump in and grab that lyric and make it your own, which Stephen is actually, they're both right. It's funny, they're both right. I never say that, but they're both right. Stephen's right too. You actually, in the end, when the choir came out, you got comfortable and you made it your own. So, I mean, it was kind of a half-half thing for me. I mean, you're still one of the greatest singers here, but grab that. Don't worry. Put all of that.
We love you, man. Can you tell how much we love you?
Put all that out your head.
Joshua. Have you processed all that?
Have you processed all of what they've said?
Oh, yes, most definitely. I mean, it was tough for me, a tough song, and I could see where J-Lo was coming from. And
I love
Randy.
You, Joshua. You know, I love you.
We love him, and he knows what we're talking about. It's just us giving our own little mentoring to him, saying things that he can improve on. That's all it is.
All right, here we go for Joshua, 1-866-IDOL-03, 1-866-436-5703. Or you can text him at 5703. All right, man, thank you very much, Joshua. Good to see you again. After this quick break, a country twist on a Billy Joel classic. Skylar is next. Don't move. Welcome back to Idol. 10 singers trying to win you over tonight, including the girl who got a little awestruck at her mentor session. Watch this.
Hi, Skylar.
Me.
Come and say hello to Diddy.
Oh, my God. He's awesome. Like, I walked in, I was shaking. I was like, I couldn't even talk.
I want to see you do your thing. You ready?
This week, I'm singing Shameless by Billy Joel. And I have a power now, but I don't want it.
It feels forced.
Well, the first time I sang, Diddy kind of said that I was pushing it. Now I got that.
Try to make the whole thing come from your heart and realize you don't have to force it. If you're telling the truth, the truth will set you free.
When she walked in, it was stiff. She was really nervous about meeting him.
I just wanted you to know.
Whoa! That's what I'm talking
about.
That
sounds a lot better.
Yeah.
Thank you. That's what I've been looking for. When you overcompensate, we lose who you are and what makes you special. And that was just perfect. Yeah, I felt like I was in church. It was beautiful.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Can I have your autograph?
Sure. I really loved this, her natural vibe, her everything.
You loved that she loved you?
Nah.
Yes.
I mean a little bit.
A little bit.
Okay. A little bit, it didn't hurt.
I'm really excited to work with one of the biggest designers in the world. Hi.
So, let's see those boots.
My mama got them for me. We are boot crazy. We have like 30 pairs of boots. I'm not even joking.
I've got an idea. I think we ought to look at what you're wearing.
Okay.
And let's try to evolve your look without abandoning the boot idea. Country Western, it's a big part of America. Let's celebrate it. Maybe with the outfit, some punch, some more color, maybe something else to lift it up and make it look a little bit more glamorous. If we could color match the boots to what she's wearing, I think she could look like a country star. You have to feel that you're looking unbelievable, and you're going to sound great as a result of that, because it'll give you a lot of self-confidence. America embraces any kind of alteration on rock. So if she takes one of those great Billy Joel songs, adds a little twang to it, I think she'll be embraced.
Do anything at all, and I'm standing here for all the world to see. There ain't that much left to me. Don't have very far to fall. You know it should be easy for someone who's strong to say they're sorry or admit when they're wrong. I never
So, you know, I remember a version of that song that Brad Paisley did was very nice. Were you thinking about that version when you chose this?
I was really thinking about Garth's version.
I forgot he did one too, yeah.
Yes, sir, I listen to that one a lot.
So. It's a great song. I mean, you know, look, the front of it, I was thinking that the key was a little low because it was a little pitchy in the very intro. Mm. But by the time you hit the middle of the song, you kind of got in your comfort zone and we heard that great Skylar that we've grown to love. So, I mean, it was pretty good. I don't know if it was your best, but it was pretty good.
Yeah. Here's what I love about you. I love your attack. You're not shameless, you're fearless. That's what you are. You just go in every song and you just eat it up, and I love it. And it's always by the end of the song, you have the whole entire audience with you, and you did the same thing with this song, so.
Skylar, I too, I'm amazed that every time you hit a chorus, you just sing it with such conviction.
Yeah.
A little slow in the beginning, but isn't that the way it was supposed to be? It was maybe a little pitchy, but you still breathe life into a song, and that's all this matters, that's all.
Yes,
it was good.
Thank you.
It was good.
All right, Skylar. How did it feel for you at the beginning of the song, listening to their point?
It is kind of low, but yeah. I mean, we had to kind of figure it out, but you know, I had the high part and I didn't want to take the high part out to make it higher on the beginning, so I mean, I think it worked out. It probably was a little bit pitchy at the beginning since it was so low, but I hope that I did good enough to stay around for next week.
All right, well, look at America. They have to vote for you here at 1-866-IDOL-04, 1-866-436-5704, or you can text the word vote to 5704. You can also vote online at AmericanIdol.com. 2 hours at the end of the show for voting. Thank you very much, Skylar.
Thank you.
After the break, Elise fights back from 2 weeks in the bottom three. Don't miss her shot live on Idol after the break. With you live on American Idol. If you're singing along at home tonight and want to keep the songs for yourself, you can do so by downloading them online, including this selection from Elise. Here we go.
Slow down, you're doing fine.
This week, I'm singing Vienna by Billy Joel.
Elise did a great performance last week, and she ended up in the bottom three. I don't know what's going on.
I'm afraid of you doing a song that no one is going to know.
You think so? I really am 100% sure that this is the song I'm supposed to be singing this week.
Let's not give up on the Vienna song. You want to be a star, let's step up to the challenge and let's take this song and let's make it special and have a special performance. Can you start with the mic on the stand? Maybe that's like throwing me off. And perform to me.
I really embraced the mood of the song more, you know, once I did it this for the second time.
Slow down, you're doing fine.
And I think that's really what won Jimmy and Diddy over, because they believed me.
Better?
Yeah, better. Would you have a chance, with this song, you have a chance to do, you have a chance to start on the mic and open yourself up, just paint the picture, and you have a chance to take the mic off and you have a chance to have fun.
It was a magical moment. How do we get that magical moment on the stage? I don't know the answer to that. Only Elise knows.
Hello.
Hi. How are you?
How are you? I'm good.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, girlfriend.
What was really interesting about Elise is that I thought she was very layered up and she was like hiding her body. And I think that sometimes that's a no-no. Could you take the scarf off and the jacket off, please?
Okay. Oh, here we go.
And who is your favorite? Who has the best style?
I love like that 70s, 60s era.
Yeah.
But I also like stuff to be fitted. Like I don't want it to be all...
Too baggy.
Yeah, too baggy.
You would look incredible in a pair of high-waisted bell bottoms.
Yeah, I've been.
That would almost go to the floor in a dark color.
Yeah.
And maybe a shorter top or maybe a short jacket on top.
I really have been on the search for a sweet pair of bell bottoms. And that's exactly what he said, which made me really excited that he kind of got me.
I think that if you like Janis Joplin and you like that 60s style, that's very cool. We can polish it up a bit and I think we'll please you.
Okay.
I have no idea what she's going to wear when she hits the stage, but I would hope that there's going to be transformation in the whole look from head to toe.
So as much as I love these bell bottoms, they're going back on the rack this week.
Slow down, you crazy child. You're so ambitious for a juvenile, but then if you're so smart, tell me why are you still so afraid? Where's the fire?
you got so much to do and only so many hours in a day. Hey, don't you know that when the truth is told, you can get what you want or you can just get old. You're gonna kick it off before it even gets halfway through. Ooh, when will you realize Vienna waits? So romantic on the borderline tonight. Tonight, you got your passion, you got your pride. Don't you know? Only fools are satisfied. Well, dream on, don't imagine they'll come true. Ooh, when will you realize Vienna waits for you? Yeah! Don't you know that when the truth is told that you can get what you want or you can just get old? You're gonna kick it off before you even get halfway through. Why don't you realize Vienna waits for you? Why don't you realize Vienna waits?
Stayed in the room. The melody was so fantastic. Just brilliant. So great singing. A lot of heart to it. More heart than, I can't believe it. You picked the song, you picked your dress. They know what they're going to do tonight with the votes. You were beautiful.
Thank you. I'm so happy for you. I'm so happy for you. I just want to shake you and hold you and squeeze you. Because it's just, it was just such a beautiful thing, and just all the different things you do with your voice and how confident you were and even the way you were moving, everything. I really feel like everybody got to see your personality for the first time, your personality in your performance, and it was really beautiful. Congratulations.
Yo, taking on Billy Joel's great songbook and great genre was going to be tough, but I like what you guys have done tonight. I like what everyone to this point has done, because you've taken it and made it your own. And what you saw tonight, America, is the reason that this girl's in this competition. She is unbelievably talented. And that vocal performance, right there, I look every night, every time we do this show, who's going to have a moment? She had a moment tonight. That run at the end is so difficult. I don't know any singers that could probably sing that other than you. Congratulations. Unbelievable. Unbelievable vocals.
Thank you.
Congratulations. We saw a shot at home, people watching, of two teenagers with, I think,
my
tears
students.
In their eyes here.
You see Mary and Mackenzie, they're amazing. Watch out
Mary
for them.
Mary and Mackenzie.
Yeah.
Come here, Mary and Mackenzie.
Come on,
let's remember the night. Come on up here. Come on, girls. Two of your students, huh?
Yes.
Well, let's make sure they never forget tonight.
Great job.
You know, I'm a vocal coach at a rock and roll school.
Yeah, that was fantastic. Come on, girls. What'd you think?
Amazing. Or use that.
It was amazing. Oh my God.
I told you
I was gonna cry.
Moments like this, that's what this is all about.
You should hear these guys sing sometime.
Well, we can make it a 3-hour show tonight and go for it.
Yeah.
All right, if you want to vote for Elise, it's 1-866-IDOL-05, 1-866-436-5705, or you can text the word VOTE to 5705. Don't do anything until the end of the show. Girls, nice to see you. Thanks for coming up on stage. You too. Good job. All right, we're going to step away for a moment. After this, Phillip Phillips takes on Moving Out live next. over 100,000 hopefuls, we are down to the top 10. The best of the best taking the stage tonight, including our former pawn shop worker, Philip Phillips, here. So this pawn shop, family-run business, used to work there. I understand since you've been on Idol, business of pawning, or as I say, pawning has picked up.
Yeah, it's picked up. You know, people, you know, pawn from alligator heads to clothes to babies to grandparents.
To babies. People are pawning babies.
Yeah.
I'm worried about this store. All right, well, ponder this. Ponder this. His week getting ready. Take a look.
Not to be rude, but I think you need some help.
I'm just like a simple kind of guy, you know? It's not like I don't care. I don't want to look like a bum up there, but, you know, I just kind of want to bring the music first.
I think Phil is a little timid, and I think he's afraid of breaking out, and maybe that's a negative.
He likes to roll his sleeves up, so I wanted to get a two-tone texture for him.
Gray is the worst color to wear on stage because it is very drab. It's very boring. It's very dull. You know, Bruce Springsteen can wear jeans and a white t-shirt, but he usually has a cool jacket on or one item that makes him Bruce. He's got to do something different than what he's doing right now because I think it's wrong. I think it'll harm his performance, and I think America will not vote the same because they're not looking at a star.
Anthony works in the grocery store.
This week I'm singing Moving Out. It's going to be fun.
I start right here. Can I hear without the guitar, please?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, can you put the guitar down?
Oh, yeah.
A lot of times when people are used to playing the guitar, it's almost like a crutch for them. And it's something they're used to having on their body. So when you expose that and you take that away, it takes them out of their comfort zone. And I think that's what you have to do to win the competition.
That's
show
right.
That you're willing to take those risks. Stop. Don't play. You gonna have that pocket, that groove there? I don't care. You got to give me something, some sort of like.
I'll
that
be grooving, man, but I can't be doing
it. No, you ain't gotta do the ditty. You ain't gotta do the ditty, but you gotta groove.
Yeah, he wanted me to get into the groove. And like I always get into the groove when I'm feeling the music, you know?
Hey, man, I never seen nobody mad at somebody dancing and having a good time.
Yo, did y'all love when he broke that down?
We need to go.
They loved it. I'm telling you. Stick with me, Phil. Stick with me. I'll take you straight to the top, baby.
They got girls up there for me to sing to, and I wasn't really all about that.
Anthony works in the grocery store, saving his pennies for some day.
You got it. We straight. We don't need no more. I don't need nobody fainting. We good.
Anthony works in the grocery store, saving his pennies for someday. Mama Leone left a note on the door. She said, son, move out to the country. Working too hard can give you a heart attack. You ought to know by now. Who needs a house out in Hackensack? Is that all you get for your money? And it seems such a waste of time if that's what it's all about. Mama, if that's moving up, then I'm moving out. I'm moving out. You should never argue with a crazy mind. Time. Is that all you get for your money? And that's what it's all about. Yeah, that's what you're all about. Mama, that's moving on now. Then I'm moving out.
I'm moving out.
Oh, if that's what you have in mind.
Moving out.
question at the end of that, maybe on your mentors there for the week, on the style and on how you sing. You know, it just comes down to it. You are who you are. You have to be who you are. And that's it. And yeah, you saw the response. Yeah, you feel the same way. Awesome.
The guitar isn't a shield for me, you know. It just becomes warm.
It's part of who you are.
Like
that's
last
right.
week, I sang it without. It's just something that's me. So.
Yeah. Well, it was a perfect rendition of that song for
that's
you.
Right.
It was great. It was great.
Great, man. You took that song and you Philip Phillips it, man. You did a really good job at that. It was beautiful. You know, I mean, someone always told the Beatles to cut their hair, Elvis to not shake his hips on television, right? You can't listen to them. I was hoping that you would do that today, that you would sing a song and blow them out of the water. I'm glad you wore gray, and you wore what you wanted to wear. Though I think maybe this scarf might help you.
Yeah.
Don't ever stop being you.
Well, let's see. Let's look at it like this, right, Stephen, Jennifer? So, Jimmy and Diddy say, take the guitar off. He didn't take the guitar.
No.
Tommy says,
Don't wear gray.
He wore gray on gray.
Yes, he did.
Okay. So wait a minute. I'll say it again. This is my second time saying it tonight. Those that do should. You just did, because you do, and you know who you are. You are an unbelievably talented artist. That's one of the best renditions of that song ever. And do. Stick to your guns. You actually know who you are, and you are really headed and going somewhere, and it was brilliant. Congratulations.
Nice. Philip Phillips.
Maybe you should give that to one of the girls up front, right? They'll probably have that. It doesn't seem like it's you.
It's you.
The microphone.
But be honest. At any point, did you... Chaos. At any point, did you consider color or paisley or pattern or anything?
Like I told him, I'm not a guy about image, you know? I want the music to be first, you know? Like, if people don't like it, that's cool. If they do, you know, it's cool too. You know, I'm not trying to sing for certain people.
You've done a great job. We're glad to have you on the show, folks. 1-866-IDOL-06. 1-866-436-5706. Or you can text the word vote to 5706. Calls are toll free from landlines. Standard text rates may apply. Lines open at the end of the show for 2 hours. Thank you very much. E squared. Appreciate it. After this, Holly tries to top her strong showing last week with more Billy Joel. Hang on. You girls gonna be all right? You okay? Tonight, we debut the top 10, the group you're going to see on the summer tour. Now, last week, Holly's dad got pretty emotional on the show. And tonight, we've got a special message from your brother Luke for you. She hasn't seen this yet. Here you go.
Hey, Holly. So I'm not going to make this dramatic and cry on national TV like Dad, because it's really embarrassing and he should be ashamed. But anyway, good luck and don't crack, because Shankly has to be seen in public. And if you mess up, he's not going to be able to leave the house. But... no pressure. Bye.
Shankly's a bit high maintenance there, huh?
He's a diva dog.
All right. Well, good luck. You can head to AmericanIdol.com to check out more behind-the-scenes videos of the contestants and their families. Here is a look at Holly's week. Take a look. 'Cause I'm your
lady. I think Holly's going to do great in this competition. The only place that was flawed was how she was dressed. They dress her so old.
I think Jimmy was absolutely on target. She did look like she was dressed like an old lady, and she doesn't need to dress like her grandmother. I would just like to have an idea of what you would like to look like.
I love kind of like all the dresses and like the sparkles.
So you want something like, glammy and with some shine?
Yeah, like dramatic, I guess you could say.
We have a lot of dresses with shine. We've got some sequins, some glitter, some sparkle.
It's every girl's dream to have somebody bring
thousands of pieces of clothes and be like, hey, do you want this, do you want that? Because, I mean, I know it's mine.
We will do our best to make you look fantastic, give you a lot of confidence on stage. And as I always say, if you've got the talent, you need the image, and then you get the whole thing. So I think we can transform her, and I think we can make her look and feel like a real star on stage. Honesty.
I'm singing Honesty.
Billy Joel, it's very public that he had a very interesting life, to say the least. A lot of salty bits, a lot of disappointments. And he looks and sings like that. You look like you were brought in a bouquet of roses today, you know? It's very powerful the first time you realize that it's not always an honest place, this world. It's a very powerful thing.
Jimmy gave her the note. I think that there was something that clicked. From you.
That was better.
Watch those tones, like the first eight bars, because once you get to that chorus, you sound incredible and you're connected to the song.
Diddy really helped me understand the meaning of the song, and he picked out points vocally, you know, that I needed to work on to really grasp the high notes. So he really put the song in a really good perspective for me.
When she realizes the disappointment and the anger to the song, I think she'll be great.
Search for tenderness, it isn't hard to find. You can have the love you need to live. But if you look for truthfulness, you might as well be blind. Always seems to be so hard to keep.
Singers, you hold the notes really long and you sing so beautifully and so deep. Tonight you were a little pitchy. It seemed like you were overthinking the song a little bit. You knew that you just hadn't sang it enough. I know in a week or so you could kill that song, but it was good. It was good.
You know, you take on these big songs, and that's great because you need to do that in this competition. I know you want to win, and I know that you can win, but at the end of the day, you have to know every single note of that song. And I know you guys have to learn them so quickly and everything, but you have to really do that when you're going to do these big songs like this. Because your voice, for me, is what the sound of your voice is one of my favorites in the whole competition this year. It really is. You have a beautiful sounding voice, especially when you go to those notes. So don't distract us by going off just slightly above or just slightly below. Gotta nail those every single time. Okay, baby?
Yeah, and I mean, let me just echo what Stephen and Jennifer said. The truth is that we give you guys constructive criticism because we think you can potentially be that great. And you can be that great. And every time I see you, I'm hoping, because I know you like these big singers, the Celine Dion's and all these kind of girls, but they're right. You have to nail each of those notes. The choruses, for the most part, were great. The verses, there were some little pitch issues, and I could feel you thinking in your head, almost in the verse, in the chorus. You know, you just gotta let go. You got that big voice, let go. You look beautiful tonight. Great job with the styling. Just, you know, tune the vocal up a little bit. Come on now, you're better than that. Come on. Ryan, how silly.
That's too tall.
Come on down here. What did you think? Did you need a few more runs with the song, or was it tough for you this week?
Yeah, this was definitely a tough week for me, and I've never heard that song, so I was just learning it. So it was, I mean, I definitely agree, and there was a bit of trouble parts for me, but I'm just hoping it was enough.
All right, well, good luck, Holly. 1-866-IDOL-07. 1-866-436-5707. Or you can text the word vote to 5707. Also, you can vote online at AmericanIdol.com. At the end of the show, Holly Kavanaugh, America, thank you very much. Just after this, what tricks does Heejun have up his sleeve tonight? Anything can happen with him. Live next. Thanks for having me on American Idol. Welcome back. Say hello to Haley Reinhardt. She's back in the audience. Good to see you.
How are you?
Good. So tomorrow night you're performing for us, right?
You got it. Right,
what are you going to do?
My new single, Free.
Okay, Free tomorrow night. Make sure you're here.
Check it out.
She'll be with us on stage. Tonight it's all about Billy Joel. If you like what you hear, you can download the tracks online, including the song Heejun is about to take on. Good to see you.
This week I chose My Life by Billy Joel.
How are you feeling after the other day?
It was pretty tough.
Yeah.
I didn't really enjoy this at all. It was pitchy all over the place.
It's been tough for me to see all these negative comments. I was heartbroken, of course. I wanted to ask you guys for advice. I just got my first criticism and it was pretty tough. And I didn't know how to handle it really well.
This is the record business. You have to have tough skin. I think you take it as constructive criticism. I try to not put my ego there, and I try to just take in what I can take in and learn from it. And I try not to make it personal.
Try to use it as fuel.
Use it as fuel.
To push you forward.
Get mad about it.
And the people that can use it as fuel belong in the game. And the people that can't, maybe should step back and say, you know what? This is not for me.
Didi and Jimmy gave me a great advice, but honestly, I'm still freaked out.
You know something? Yes, you got criticized, and you're still standing. So it's all right. You know what I'm saying?
You're here. I heard you're here, so I just wanted to see you.
What's up? I'm here, baby.
Hey.
Hey. Hug. Come here.
It's all right.
I'm here. Let's go.
Let's do it, man.
I don't know if he's an actor or...
I think he's a little of everything.
A con man or... I don't even know if he's Asian. Maybe black. I haven't figured him out yet. We have to keep an eye on him.
Heejun, how are you?
Nice to meet you. Well, obviously, I'm a really fashionable guy, as you can see. So I'm really glad that I'm working with Tommy Hilfiger.
If you were to think of someone you really look up to who has fashion sense, who would it be?
Jessica Sanchez.
I think Heejun was testing me.
Madonna.
Okay, now what about a man? And I think he wanted to see if I was going to push him.
Michael Bolton. I'm not really into fashion. I'm just gonna wear anything they give me. I'm looking at you right now. Mm-hmm. Like, I really wanna try something like this too.
Look, you have to do what you wanna do because I'm only here advising you. Mm-hmm. And I don't want to say, you have to do this because that's not really what I'm here for.
Well, Tommy told me to find my own stylist and performance, so I might bring a really, really big surprise tonight.
Ray, that's just much too slow for me. And I wanna dance! Got a call from an old friend, we used to be real close. Said he couldn't go on the American way.
home. Yeah, yeah. I don't care what they say anymore. This is my life. Go ahead with your own life. Leave me alone. I never said I wasn't up for me a second chance. I never said I was a victim of circumstance. I should belong. Don't get me wrong. And you can keep your time, but not on my time. I don't need you to worry for me, 'cause I'm alright. I don't need you to tell me it's time to come home.
Jennifer Lopez, what did you think of that, man?
I love that you brought a little fun to tonight. There's been a lot of ballads tonight,
definitely.
And so that was like a breath of fresh air. I don't think, you know, yes, it was, wasn't it? Wasn't that fun? You know, I don't know, you know, because you were running around and everything, I think that you didn't hit the vocal exactly the way that you would have liked to, that I know you can.
Lopez.
That's right. You're so sweet. But it was a lot of fun, and I really enjoyed it.
He-Man. He-Man. You know, I'm a little tongue-tied. Are you happy that you took the piss out of that song?
What is that?
I mean, you told him, right? You Whoa. Showed him. You told him.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And I'm glad you did. I hope it made you feel good inside, but they were right. The music business will kick your ass. At some point, you got to try and take it more serious. Just a little bit more. You got a great voice, and yeah.
What? Oh, look, here's the deal, right? Last week, it was like a little rough. You know, look, for me, at least you had a good time, and it was definitely entertaining. There was still some vocal problems, but as much as you were entertaining, I was just happy to see you have a good time. At least that, because we've become to know you as this funny dude that does all this cool, funny kind of stuff. So I love that part of it. Vocally, it was definitely missing a bit, but still, you had a good time. So I was entertained. I think you guys were entertained, right?
Definitely an unconventional performance here on American Idol.
Yeah.
Going back to Diddy's confusion about who you are, what do you make of that?
I think Diddy is actually confusing in himself already, so I don't know if he can, like, but Diddy's a good guy, so I love you, Diddy. Sean John.
And how did you feel about that lap you did? How did you feel about the song tonight?
It was really long. I never knew this stage was really big.
Yeah.
Until I ran around. It was pretty big. I'll never do it again. It's really
If you want to vote for Heejun, 1-866-8008. 1-866-436-5738. Or you can text him and vote to 5708. Don't vote until the end of the show. The one and only Heejun, America. All right, take care. Come on, it's camera time, baby. Coming up next, on the other side, the Pride of San Diego gets her shot. Jessica Sanchez next. All right, now. Welcome back. Welcome back. We're still talking about Heejun's performance here during the commercial break.
Very funny.
Interesting. Up next is Jessica. Here we go.
I love shopping. I love clothes. When I found out that Tommy Hilfiger is coming on the show, I was freaking out.
You excited?
Very.
Nervous?
Yeah, of course.
Maybe we could relieve some of that by making you look amazing.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's a great idea you wear a dress because of your size. Can we have a look at it?
Yeah.
Now, how about the length on that? Where does it come to? Because you might want to shorten it just a little bit. On a petite girl, you either want to be very long or quite short. If you have the lace dropping below your knee, it may make you look shorter than you really are. And I think you want to look taller. But I think the dress is very cool for you. I think the audience will love it.
Yay.
Jessica, she's got the ability to not only be a music icon, but a fashion icon.
Hi, Jessica. Come on, say good day.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
How are you?
I'm great. This week, I'm going to be singing Everybody Has a Dream by Billy Joel.
Everybody has a dream. No, no.
See, I have a responsibility to be honest with you.
Of course.
Like, I don't believe you. And I just think that you're over-singing the song. I just want to believe that you have that dream.
When Diddy said that he didn't believe in my song and the way that I was singing it, it really did, you know, give me that extra push.
You have to pull back on the showing off the tricks. Tricks are not going to get you to that superstar level.
I think less is more. Too much vibrato will get her in trouble.
When you are looking at someone, you are 1,000% more believable. Do me a favor this time. Sing the song to Diddy.
I believe you now.
We're gonna all have Diddy masks on when we come to the show. And you just think to all of us.
That's it.
Jessica's definitely a star, but it's up to her to take her time and pay respect to the song.
In these days, quiet desperation. As I wander through the world in which I live, I search everywhere some new inspiration. It's more than cold reality can be.
Past my judging. When God was giving out vocal cords, you were so at the front of the line.
Thank you so much.
I've got nothing to say except thank you for letting me hear you sing, baby.
I love that song. Was was like written for you. Like he wrote that song for you a long time ago. That's like that was the defining moment for you, for me, a defining song, because I really feel like that's you. That's you. You have this dream and you're here and you're seizing the moment and you're living it in every second. And we all get to feel that, and that's a beautiful thing. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Yo, what I'm loving is doing this show for now 11 seasons, it takes consistency to win. Every time you step up, every week, you have to have a moment. You have a moment every time you step on that stage, and I love it. You're flawless. It was perfect. And let me just say this. Let me add this, guys. Let me throw this in, Rod. Yo, Jimmy, Diddy, Tommy, excellent mentoring, excellent style, excellent coaching. Everybody was right on. That was perfection. Excellent.
Come on over to your red carpet here. Good job.
Thank you.
How did that feel while you were singing it?
Felt amazing. I mean, I sang what I believed in. I have a dream, and this is my dream.
And this is it. If you want to vote for Jessica, 1-866-IDOL-09, 1-866-436-5709, or you can text the word VOTE to 5709. You can also vote online at AmericanIdol.com. At the end of the show, thank you very much. That was wonderful.
Thank you.
Great job. Hey, when we come back, it's Colton at the Keys. Be right back live. Song for you tonight before we open up the lines and you take control. It's coming to you from Colton.
What do you see your image as being?
You know, I don't want to go after a certain person. I kind of want to create my own style.
I really enjoyed Colton, and I love the fact that he was so explicit and clear with what he wanted to be.
Very edgy.
Very edgy.
Punk rock, and I love the military style, kind of a combination of those.
I think he's very capable of being a star. Now let's see your hair.
Oh boy, hat hair.
Okay.
I'm thinking, awesome, he's gonna size me up based on hat hair, that's great.
Could you turn around?
Yes.
Let's see, okay. I'm a little worried about the hair because I think the hair takes away from it rather than adds to it. We should think about what to do with your hair after we look at the outfit. Because okay. I think the outfit is going to dictate sort of the image. And then we have to tweak around it.
My hair's my baby. I was planning on doing something a little different anyway, but I hate that he immediately discredited it. It's kind of like, okay, cool. Enough said.
How you doing, my man? Good. Pleasure to meet you. See you.
All right. What song are you doing, sir?
Piano Man.
All right, well, there you go.
Yeah, the past couple weeks, I haven't been anywhere near a piano, and I've missed it. So I think Billy Joel Week is the perfect opportunity to get back in my comfort zone and really give it all I've got.
It's 9 o'clock on a Saturday.
Well, to me, Colton's got the advantage tonight. Talk about a song made for a kid. This song is tailor-made for him, plays the piano, sings it great.
I actually wanted to buy that record when he got finished with it.
That was great.
Yeah.
You loved this song. When you heard it was Billy Joel Week, you was like, ooh, I got one for him.
There was one note he switched up that I thought didn't resolve the hook as well. It sounds like you're singing an alternate note for the word man.
Yes.
Yeah.
So you saw me on the piano, man.
Do you want me to go down there?
Yeah, let's hear the original note.
Okay.
I would keep it the original way, though. I just
really?
I loved his note.
I don't like them to change it too much, but a little bit of taking ownership of the record, I like.
It made me look at you as an artist and not Billy Joel.
He knows where the song lives.
Yep.
It's 9 o'clock on a Saturday. Crowd shuffles in. There's an old man sitting next to me, making love to his tonic and gin. He says, son, can you play me a memory? I'm not really sure how it goes, but he
it sounded it sweet, and I knew it complete when I wore a younger man's clothes. And you got us all feeling alright. La da 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 da. La da 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 da. Sing us a song, you're the piano man. Sing us a song tonight.
From head to toe, from the minute you started. And you know what? Diddy gave you, I was gonna say Puffy, but Diddy gave you the biggest compliment, saying he would buy that record the minute you finished singing, and I agree. Great job.
Your choice of chords when your voice resolved was stunning. It was just outrageous. You're a great musician and a great singer. Yeah.
What I love, dude, is that what you said to Tommy, that you want to be an individual. That's what this is about. I mean, this great Billy Joel songbook, I mean, you guys have done amazing things with it. Most of you have done some very interesting arrangements to them, and you gave a very sensitive, touching, moving performance on one of his classics when you couldn't even make it any different, but just making it so simple made it different. And by the way, I love the hair, I love the voice. You definitely are a rock star, baby. I like it. I like it. Stay individual. Be an individual.
Nice, man. Great job. Come on over here. So just before you started to play, just before we took that big wide shot, what were you thinking about in that moment? Because you were taking your time.
We love you, Colton.
I love you guys. Thank you.
He's all yours in 4 minutes.
You know, I've been praying before this whole thing because tonight was a big moment for me. And I was just collecting myself and saying, you know, God, use me. I wanted to shine through first and foremost. So, you know, you can feel the emotion.
Colton's number is 1-866-IDOLS-10. 1-866-436-5710. If you're with AT&T, you can text the word vote to 5710. Or you can vote online at AmericanIdol.com. Voting real soon. Colton, thank you very much. Here are the phone numbers. Take a look.
The more behind.
Phil Phillips, Colton, Dog.
Yeah, Elise for me and Colton, Jessica.
Jessica, Colton, Elise, and Philip.
All right. Thanks, guys. The lines are open. They'll stay open for at least 2 hours. If you've never cast a vote on the show, do it tonight. It's simple. Call, click, or text. Support your favorite. Thank you very much for watching. Tomorrow night, we're back with results and much more. 8-7 Central. Your local news is next right here on Fox. Good night, America.